In today's session, we are going to discuss on topic support reaction. Basically, we focus on compound beam. Myself, Bipin Patil, Assistant Professor, Department of Civil Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. So, my dear friends, these are the learning outcomes for today's session. At the end of this particular session, student will be able to explain the function of compound beam. What do you mean by compound beam? Second, analyze and calculate the support reactions for compound beam. So, my dear friends, you just focus on this particular figure. First point is present, the definition of compound beam. Basically, there are four types of supports: simple support, fixed support, one in hinge, other on roller. Just like you just consider here, different types of loads are also present: point load, inclined load, uniformly distributed load, uniformly varying load. If we consider two supports and only one member is present, we call that simply supported beam. If one end is fixed and at other end there is no support, we call that fixed beam. At one end hinge support, other end roller support, we call that one end hinge and other end roller support. Just like compound beam is present here now. Now you just observe this particular figure. A, B, C, these are nothing but your nodal points. A and C, simple support is there. And B, here we have just connected two members by using one internal pin or roller. On this particular first segment, AB, second one, BC is there. On AB segment, we are consider here one additional external load is there, that is P. Sometimes we call it as point load. And BC, there is no support, or there is no external load is present there. The span of your first segment is L1, span of second segment is L2. Now, what do you mean by compound beam? So, you just observe here, when beam consists of two or more than two members, so here we are considered two members or more than two members, it is connected by internal pin or roller. So, internal pin is present here, roller. Such beam is called as compound beam. Now, you just observe here, these two particular beams are connected by using this particular pin or roller, we call as compound beam is there. So, how to analyze this particular beam? Means how to calculate the reactions for this particular beam? Now, basically, the sign conventions are very important before solving any problems. So, two parts we just consider here. One is positive sign. Second one is negative sign. How to bifurcate it? All vertical upward forces consider positive sign. All vertical downward forces consider negative sign. All right hand side forces you just consider positive sign. All left hand side forces you just consider negative sign. Clockwise rotary effects consider positive sign. Anticlockwise rotary effects consider negative sign. Now, these are the steps to identify the reactions. So, determination of beam reactions. First step. Now, you just observe or remember previous slide. Two members are present, two segments are present, AB and BC is there. So, first one, you just consider second segment. Draw the free body diagram of the structure showing the given loading and the reactions at the supports. Means you just remove this particular support, mention only simple support, and by considering that particular simple support, you just mention the external loads. It may be point load, maybe your UDL, maybe your UVL. Basically, second step, consider the topmost beam. That is nothing but the second segment. An analysis done by considering this particular topmost beam and find the reactions. Third step, apply the static equilibrium equation. That is, the three equations are present: summation f of x is equal to 0, summation f of y is equal to 0, and summation m is equal to 0. So here you just consider some directions. That is nothing but the sign conventions already were discussed. By referring these particular sign conventions, you just identify the reactions. And last one step is there, by using this particular equation, you just identify the unknown reactions. We discuss one problem. Determine the reactions at support A, support C, and D in the compound B as shown in figure. B is nothing but the internal pin or roller is there. So as we discuss here in our steps, AB is a topmost beam. So first you just identify the reaction present over this particular beam. Then whatever the reactions are present on this particular beam, it acts in a downward direction as a point load to this particular second segment. So our first step is, by considering this particular geometry, this particular figure, you just remove the supports, mention the simple support, and try to draw free body diagram for this particular given figure. Similarly, mention external loads. So this is the solution. First one, consider first segment AB. That is, you just consider one moment center A, and you just apply first equilibrium equation, that is summation m at point A is equal to 0. Now on this particular segment AB, only one external load is there, that is 180 kiloton, and this is your moment center. So this force into lateral distance or horizontal distance, that is nothing but the moment. So 180 into 3, that is, it creates clockwise. So you just consider positive sign. Second one, minus RB into this total distance, that is 4, and it creates anti-clockwise rotary effect. So we consider negative sign. Now by solving this particular equation, we get the answer RB is equal to 135 kiloton. Second, you just apply static equilibrium equation, summation f of v is equal to 0. Now here we are considering all vertical upward forces on left hand side, all vertical downward forces on right hand side. So see here, RA plus RB is equal to 180. Already we have calculated the value, that is this particular equation number 1, RB. Put this particular value in this particular equation, calculate the value of RA, and it comes 45 kiloton. Similarly, consider segment CD. Now whatever the value you have calculated here, that is RB 135 kiloton, it acts in a downward direction over this particular segment, and this particular distance they are mentioning in 0.5 meter. So now you just consider C as your movement center. Summation of movement at point C is equal to 0. So see, first one RB, it creates here anti-clockwise, right? So RB into this 0.5, it creates anti-clockwise rotary effect, so negative sign. Minus, there is no any external load present over this particular segment CD. So you just consider only this particular support reactions. Minus RD into this 4. Now put the value of RB here. Now you just consider this part here in right hand side. Do the arrangement and calculate the value of RD. So the value of RD is 16.875 kiloton. So this is for segment C to D. So just like you just calculate the support reaction present at support A, C, and D for compound beams. Similarly, apply second static equilibrium equation, summation f of v is equal to 0. So all vertical upward forces on left hand side, all vertical downward forces on right hand side, RC plus RD is equal to RB, that is 135. From equation number 2, here already we have calculated, put the value in this particular equation, calculate the value of RC. So it comes 151.275 kiloton. Just like you just calculate the support reactions present at A, C, and D supports. Now my dear friends, you just pause the video and try to give the answer of this particular question. This is the answer of this particular question. To prepare this particular session, I referred these particular references. Thank you.